Hey guys, what's up? And today I'm going to show you how to fall, well, collapse
the Origami Mantis Shrimp by Andre Ermakov. It can be found in Origami School of Masters or in Origami Tantan Convention number 17.
So, let's get started. So, I don't have the beginning of the film for getting right here, but you can sort of see what happened. So, what we did was we basically made a lot of pleats right here. Pleated these all the way down, and same on this side, all the way down, like this. And then on the inside, you can see what happened. We just made pleats along these lines, then collapsed it like this. Make sure this is tight. You don't want to crease this edge, just keep it loose, but you can crease all in here. And then this side. So now we can turn it back over. And you sort of understand what happened right here. So now we can continue. Okay, so now what we're going to do, well, you should have 9 pleats. So, now what we're going to do is we're going to make giant folds that go all the way down. So, we're going to start by, what we're going to do is at this corner right here, we're going to make a mountain fold on this and a valley fold on this. So, press this in. And I'm going to start by making this mountain fold all the way down. Like this. I'm gonna turn it over and fold this edge up, and you can pleat this all the way like that. And then bring this all the way down, like this. Then this right here. And you can make sure this is neat here. Like this. Now you can put it back over. And you will see that we have this. Sure, nothing gets caught up in there. Now we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So right here, open this up, make this mountain fold like that. And now bring this all the way down, or partially down. Now you can turn it back over. And continue this all the way down. you can open this, I can feed it with this, if it's easier. Now turn it back over. Like this. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to focus down on this corner and we're going to undo this, and you will see where we pre-creased the square right here. You're going to take this and make a mountain fold right along this, reversing the crease, I guess. And then this will be two mountain folds, this mountain fold, and then this, it's gonna happen, is just like on Ryujin scales, this is gonna come like this, and this will fold over. So now we're gonna do the same thing on this side. So just, it will sort of collapse naturally, but just like that. Now we're going to open this up like this and do the same thing on all of these. So technically we're just releasing the paper in the corners. And it should look something like this. Now we're gonna just do the whole thing all the way down, over and over again. Well, no, just do the first two. Okay, so we only do that for these first two. So what we're going to do next is we're going to make another pleat that goes in and out. And then we will get the other ones. So, let's do that. I'm going to start by making this mountain fold like this. The pleat is right alongside the other one, so it shouldn't be that hard. And then just sort of wrap this corner around. Press this in like that. Bring this down. Now we can just fold this over. And you'll see we have something like this. This goes in there. Like this. So now that this is pleated, it should look like this. Then we can open this up. Well, this one right here. And do this. Make the mountain fold. like this. Fold this down. It's sort of hard because of this angle, but basically you just do this. Make the creases, tuck this in here. And then you want to pull right here. This should be on top of the other one. Like this. And then this should come down. So now close this down like this. And do the same thing on the other side. So first make the pleat. Like this. Press this in. And then you can start to make this. Makes it a little bit easier before you collapse most of this. Now continue this pleat right here. And you should have this. And these are done. So now we have this. Okay, so the next one's a little bit tricky. What you have to do, instead of just making a reverse fold, you have to, right here, you're just going to press this in. That's what I did. And reverse these creases. Like this. And then this comes in like that. This comes out. Like this, and then this presses in. So it should look like that. Or that's what I'm doing. So again, we press this in like that, then this in like that. I will show you again on the other side. Now I'm going to tuck this under. And there's actually one we forgot to do on the previous one right here. So I'm going to open that up and do that one. It's under this one. Take this, fold it over. Then collapse it like this. And same thing right here. Now we can use the ones that we just made the pleat for. I'm gonna continue this all the way down. Like that. And now I'm going to make the pleat on this side. So we're going to open this up and make this pleat right here. But to do that, we have to take this edge, these right here. Take this right here, press it in. Like that. Then we can make this mountain fold. And this valley fold. And then we can take this and just press that in like that. Then this will close up around it. So now we have this. And we can come down here. And we have to make this fold. So unwrap this. Make this a mountain fold. Then from behind, pull this layer over this one. Like that. And then this can all slide into place. Like that. Now we can do the same thing right here. So continue this all the way down. That, hold this down. Then we can just close this around. And then that fits neatly like this. Then now we should have this. Now, we are going to make, we have, let's see. Okay, we have one more pleat to make on this side. So open this up. Make this fold right here. Bring this across. It's a mountain fold. Go to the last one here. And then bring this down. So now we should have this, and you can just close it up on the side. Align that, and then collapse this. Now, we're going to do another one of the tricky collapses. So, push this in, well, pleats. Push this in, like that, as a closed sink. Then you can pleat this. Then press this in. and just press this in. Now you can just beat this like that. Then we can make the last three pleats. So we can open this up. This time it's actually pretty far. Make a mountain fold. Like this, bring this down. Now get this right here. Grab it from behind and tuck it in like this. Do the same here. Get it to look like this. Now we'll do the same thing on this side. Open it up. And we also have to make... Oh, no, 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 no. Yes, we have to make the pleat on this side. So take this, press it in. Bring it all the way down. Then this can sort of swivel like that, and you can continue this right here. And then pleat this. Okay. Now we have this. And we have two more left to do. I'm gonna try opening both sides. See if that makes it easier. Doing it both at the same time. So, now we have this. And we just have one more to reverse. Right here. Now we can press this in. And this side, last time. Now we have this. Just gonna close off these a little bit. And now we should have this. All of these are fully put in place. Like that. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're just going to reverse fold these in some more. We don't have to worry about these right now, but we just have to reverse fold these around up to here. So that's what we're gonna do. Take this and press it in. Like that. At corner. No, sorry. We're going to start with this corner. Take that, press it in. Bring this all the way here. And now we're going to make this key like that. Now we have this, and we can bring this all the way down. Like this. Now this should be ready. And we can do that again. Push that in. And this is the last one that we have to make. We had to make 5 or 6. I'm not sure. But this is the last one. Like this, and we can press this in. So basically now we have this. This should come up like that. Like this. Now we have this. Right here. Now I'm just gonna do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to make a valley fold right here. And then we're gonna count 1, 2, 3. And on the third, we're gonna make a mountain fold. Like this, and then continue it all the way down. I'm mostly just gonna leave this here and clip it off with a clip or something right here, because this is the main thing that we are looking for right here. Okay, so now we have this right here, and What we're going to do is we're going to make some stretches. So I'm gonna take this off to open this up. And what we're gonna do is open this up like this. This is like what we do in the feet for the ancient dragon. And we're going to make this right here. Then we're gonna sort of make a square. Like this. Push the square together and fold each side down. Now we're gonna do that for all the corners. I'm gonna show you two more times, then I'm gonna let you do it on your own. So, we're gonna open this up, make a square using the unit, the grid. And then we're going to press this in. That and burn this down. Like this. Now I'm going to let you finish all those steps on your own. And what we're going to do now is we're going to turn it over like this. And I'm going to fold all this to one side, and I'm just going to focus right here. But what you want to do is, if you look at this closely, you'll see we have this right here. We want to fold this over like that. Now do the same thing to this point. And just continue that all the way down. Now repeat that on the other side. So now we're going to take a pencil or something and just press this in, just like sink it. You can just fold it over like that or reverse fold it. Like that, I'm probably gonna reverse fold it. You can also sink it, but that is a little bit harder. Reverse folding makes sure that it stays closed. So. Just continue that all the way down. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next tutorial.